Well, good afternoon and welcome to Hope Lives Here. This is a beautiful, beautiful day. And I know you're going to have a blessed day and you are believing the Lord for great things. I know I am. We're in a period of time in the history of the church that we're shifting into a new place and a new way of doing things. But our mind is also shifting. Our mind is shifting from thinking that we have to work toward receiving anything from God, or that God is a hard taskmaster and we have to earn what we receive from Him. And I'm staying on this subject because many have commented that they have fell in this place of wanting to try to do something to earn God's favor. I'm Apostle Dolores Kendrick. We're located here in the Seattle area, and I didn't want to forget that for those of you that might be new coming listening today. And we're Tabernacle of Praise Church, and we are excited over what God is doing in the Pacific Northwest. We know that there is crime everywhere, and it's just tragedies happening all over, but we know that God is not asleep. He's not dead. He's very much alive, and He has a purpose in all that He allows. Note that I said that He allows, that He is not doing. He is not doing this. This is a work of the enemy. This is a work of flesh, but we know that as we pray, and as God brings us to a place of humility, to bow our knees to Him and to continue to seek Him more than ever, that God is going to answer our prayer. Amen. I thank God for those on the prayer team. Sister Bev Evans, that leads the prayer on Monday at 6 a.m., Wednesday at 6 a.m., and Friday at 6 a.m. I thank God for that, and it's growing, and we are seeing results that's taking place of miracles. We cannot pray enough. I thank God for those that come at Friday evening, praying and believing God, and because of it, we're seeing great things take place. And also Sunday morning at 9 o'clock, Pastor Jamie and Cynthia that lead in prayer. I thank God for all the prayer, because we cannot pray enough, and we're seeing some things that's happening, and all that take place is causing us to bow our knees, hallelujah, and pray, and not only on those times, but in our homes, seeking God like we never sought Him before, for the great things that God has already done for us. And I say already done. The word of the Lord, it says, blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ, in His Son, with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places. We know that we have access, hallelujah, to the blessings and the inheritance that God has provided for us. I've often, as I said before, had people ask me, why would God want to bless me? I've not done anything that would cause Him to want me to have this or have that. They feel that it's for the ministry. They feel that it's for the one that of a fivefold ministry. They feel that it's for those that pray a lot, or what they term as God's people that really do something for the Lord. And they look at what they see with their natural eyes, and they think that these people are just great people and they are deserving. But I want you to know that God didn't just give His life and shed His blood and was whipped, hallelujah, with that cat of nine tails. He did not go through that suffering just for a fivefold ministry, or just for leaders and those that we feel are great people in God. He did it for the world. He did it for the little person, the little insignificant person that no one pays any attention to. He died, and He gave His life and gave the benefits of that sacrifice to all all those who would call upon his name. Amen. And if you have called upon the name of the Lord, hallelujah, and accepted him into your life, you have access to all the benefits that heaven has to offer. It grieves my heart to hear people act as though that they are not worthy. None of us are worthy, but he has made us worthy, hallelujah, through the blood that he shed at Calvary. And so it grieves me because that shows me that they don't really understand the work at Calvary. They don't understand the love of God. They don't understand the grace and the mercy of God. They do not understand the debt that Christ paid for us so we can receive the benefits of his blessings. Hallelujah. So much of what we do can be an attempt to try to earn the favor of God. We cannot work to receive the favor of God. Instead, we must learn how to enjoy that access that God have given us through Christ Jesus, all the blessings and all the benefits of healing and deliverance and freedom from curses. Hallelujah, that he paid the price for us. Christianity is not about people reaching out to a holy God trying to be worthy of him. It's about a holy God, hallelujah, paying the penalty of our sin through the blood of his own son, now making us worthy of his blessings. Hallelujah. Can you just lift your hands and say, I'm worthy? I'm worthy of the blessings of God, not by anything that I have done, but what Christ has done for me. When I think back on my life and I look back at my parents, and I think about all the mistakes that I did growing up and all the things that I did. I was a naughty kid and I got spanked and so forth. But that had nothing to do with the love and the care that my parents, they still cared for me. Yes, they spanked me because they loved me. Remember, we used to hear them say, I'm spanking you now, I'm whipping you because I love you. Yeah, right. But it's true. They were teaching us. But it had nothing to do with them not loving us or caring for us, because we are their children. And when I think back even on my children, they're my children. So everything that I have, they have access to. They have access to. And this is the way it is with Father God. We have access, but it's through Jesus Christ, to all the benefits, through all the blessings, through all that heaven has, we have access because we have been adopted into the family of God. The Spirit himself, Romans 8:16 said, testifies with our spirit that we're the children of God. And if children, we're heirs also, heirs of God, fellow heirs with Christ, if indeed we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him. So receiving from God is not according to the works that we have done, but according to his grace. That grace in Christ Jesus, hallelujah, he qualified us to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints, hallelujah. This means that he has made us worthy. Yes, he's made you worthy. Being born again, you can boldly declare that you have the life and nature of God in you. You're an heir of God's infinite blessings, glory to God, and they are amazing. They are, it is an abundance of blessings that he has for us. Jesus made it possible, hallelujah, because it's not of works. We all could boast of what we do, but that has nothing to do with it. Hallelujah. We have access and we have the benefits of God's love and his blessings. We prosper and be in health. That's his desire, even as our soul. So that means our spirit, soul, body, we prosper in Christ because of the work of Calvary. So do not say, I'm not worthy. That hurts the spirit of the Lord. Don't ever say, I'm not worthy to receive his benefits. Say, yes, I'm worthy, not because of what I've done, but because of what he has done. I can be healed. I can receive my miracle. I can, because I am worthy, because the blood is upon me, because I am a child of God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. What an awesome revelation to you to receive. When you receive that, now you begin to claim it. You begin to proclaim it. You begin to speak it. You begin to declare it. Hallelujah. And you will see the manifestation of what you declare. Amen. Praise the Lord. God bless you. And time just runs out really fast. Have a precious, precious day, as I know you will. God bless you.